Hey guys, welcome to another math lesson by Bulletproof Monk Academy. In this lesson, you're going to learn about fractions. And fractions is actually one of the most important concepts in maths. And everyone needs to learn fractions in order to advance onto more difficult maths. So I would suggest that you learn this properly and that you refer back to this video anytime you forget how to do fractions. Now we're going to start from the beginning, which means you pretty much don't need any prior knowledge on fractions. So if you already know a little bit about fractions, you can probably fast forward a little bit. But I would suggest that you watch through the whole video if it's your first time. So equivalent fractions. So firstly, let's draw a little pizza. So let's pretend this is a pizza. Now, if we divide this pizza into two, and we highlight one of the two slices. Now, this section that we've highlighted, we represent it as a half, 1/2. Now why do we say 1/2? Because we have divided the pizza into two slices and we're only highlighting one of them. Now the number at the top, we call this number here the numerator, and we call the number at the bottom the denominator. So those are two terms that you have to understand when you hear people talk about fractions. Now, what happens if I have the same pizza and I divide it into four equivalent slices and I highlight two of the slices? So I highlight two of the slices. Now, this highlighted section can be represented as 2/4. And why do we say 2/4? Because we have divided the pizza into four slices, equivalent slices, and we are highlighting two of them. Now, what have you noticed about the sections we have highlighted? Is they are both the same size. So these two things are equal, which means a half is actually equal to 2/4. So how do we go from a half to 2/4? Well, you have probably realized that all we have done is we multiply by 2 on both the numerator and the denominator. So 1 times 2 at the top, 1 times 2, put the answer at the top, is 2. 2 times 2, the answer is 4. Now, you are allowed to multiply or divide by whatever you want as long as you do it to both the top and the bottom. So let's do another example. If we have a half, let's times by 5 on both the top and the bottom. So that is equal to 5/10. So what that means is a half is equal to 5/10. So with fractions, if you multiply the same number by the numerator and the denominator, then you actually end up with an equivalent fraction. So if you can, try to give me as many equivalent fractions, list all equivalent fractions. Equivalent fractions for let's say 1/4. Well, when I say all, I just mean as many as possible. As many as possible. So don't list all of them. List as many as possible equivalent fractions for 1/4. Come back when you're done. Okay, so we have 1/4. Now, let's multiply both the top and the bottom by 2. Then we get 2/8. So 2/8 is an equivalent fraction. Now, what if you multiply by 3 on both the top and the bottom? Then you get 3/12. What about if you multiply by 4? Then you get 4/16. So all of these are equivalent fractions. Equivalent fractions for 1/4. Right? So you can write it as 1/4, 1/4 equals 2/8 equals 3/12 equals 4/16. Okay, once you understand the concept of equivalent fractions, you can then be asked to simplify fractions. Simplify fractions. And that's when you have, for example, a really big fraction. Let's put down 35/45 equals. Now these two are very big numbers, and it's quite easy to get confused with fractions when the numbers are really big. We want to make them as small as possible, and we want to make sure that our answer is a equivalent fraction. So what we're going to do is divide both the top and the bottom numbers, but divide both the numerator and the denominator by the same number. So we're going to try dividing both of them by 5. Divide by 5 on both numerator and the denominator. So 35 divided by 5 is 7, and 45 divided by 5 is 9. So we have just simplified it. Now let's try simplifying 300/400. Okay, another very big number, but if you think of a number that you can divide both of these numbers by, and that is 100. So if you divide both by 100, and 400 divided by 100, then you get 3/4. So in order to simplify fractions, make sure you are dividing by the same number on both the numerator and the denominator until you get to the simplest fraction. Now let's try a more difficult one. Let's say 36/16. Okay, so let's divide by 2, right? Because if you can see that both numbers end with an even number, so see how both of the numbers end with an even number? Then that means you can start by dividing it by 2. So 36 divided by 2, 16 divided by 2. So 36 divided by 2 equals 18. 16 divided by 2 equals 8. Now both of these numbers still end with even numbers. See how they're both still even. So that means you can divide by 2 again, and then you end up with 9/4. And now you can see that on the top we have an odd number. So this is odd and this is even. So that usually means it'll be pretty difficult to simplify any further. And you can see That's what's happened here with that one, 3/4, odd, even. If they're both odd, then you might need to just see if you can think of a number that you can simplify them down with. Okay, thanks for watching the first tutorial on fractions. We shall continue with more fractions in the next tutorial. See you next time.